The youth of today don't listen. They think it's cool, the thought of going to prison. I spend my life trying to get them to think about their choices, and sometimes it feels like I'm speaking with foreign voices. You tell them ways to change. You tell them there's change to be made. You tell them there's a whole wide range of things to help them change. But they're too afraid. All you can do is hope. Hope that the advice that you gave on better ways to make cash register and just hand it over. When deep down you know that the whole time they're thinking, open the cash register and just hand it over. We need to invent time travel, because while they think that they know more, the older them could settle the score, because there's a score to be settled. And every rose will have a thorn, but every thorn is outnumbered by rose petals. And rose petals are the bits that everyone likes. And every naughty kid has that rose-tinted light, that ability to change and walk away from a fight. We just need to find a light switch and slowly change the balance, making a light switch. And yes, it is a challenge, but what doesn't challenge you doesn't change you. And in my view, you can't preach to them until you've made a change with you. This is a subject where qualifications struggle to teach, so we use our life experiences and we go to schools to preach. They need to know there's a lesson they could learn, but they won't listen because the money that they earn, being dishonest, is a hell of a lot more than any job, living honest. So you tell them about consequences, about your friends who have passed, about awful prison food and the effect of it on your ass, about how the only type of money that can be confiscated is a type that you make fast. But even if one listens and you change that one's perspective and they finally hear your message and choose a new way to live, then it's worth it and it's job done. Because when it comes to saving lives, I'm happy with just one.